Basically, we want to make all of you into muktas. What does that mean? The problem is very simple. You want to become a mukta. That is the problem. If you try stopping to be a mukta, you are a mukta. That's where the trick is. How can you become something else other than what you are? How can a mango become a tomato? No. You are what you are, but the problem is you don't accept yourself, you don't love yourself, you go on comparing with others, you think something else is wonderful. Nothing is more wonderful than drinking a glass of water. But your mind should not interfere. You know, drinking a glass of water, the mind is going on commenting on the water or thinking about what has happened already or what is going to happen. That's why you are stuck. A beggar can be a mukta, a karotpati can be a mukta. But the beggar who is a mukta is far superior to a karotpati who is not a mukta. Now the thing is, you are not accepting yourself. Unless you accept yourself, you cannot love yourself. If you cannot love yourself, how are you going to love your wife or husband or anybody for that matter? You don't accept your body, you don't accept your position in society, you don't accept your knowledge. Everything is, yeah, it could have been better. I could have been an Einstein. Einstein had so many problems. Why do you want to be like Einstein? So, you are you. Everybody is special. That's how you are made. The problem is you are not accepting yourself. All we are trying to do is, through so many techniques and methods and teachings, to make you accept yourself as you are. You are designed like that. Your genes are like that. Your brain is like that. So, the awakened one, not that he is great, he simply accepts himself. He may be by the gutter, but accepts himself. You may be in a palace, but you do not accept yourself. If you know who you are and you accept yourself as you are a mukta. It's all over. Then you see, then you are living.